Hey, YouTube. Today, we're going to talk about how to leverage your content in search with large language models. Classically, we've thought of search as being keyword searches like Google's ranking algorithm, taxonomies for hierarchical search, and ontologies for relationship searching. But now we want to be able to ask natural questions of our information, and large language models empower us to do that. And using the right infrastructure, it's not that difficult to get it done. We'll be using Pinecone database today alongside Ada Embeddings to empower our content for search. Let's get started. What we would like to be able to do is not only search our information, but ask relevant questions around it. In this case, I've taken the PubMed public dataset and just uploaded it to a vector database using Ada Embeddings, and now I am able to ask very relevant questions of my corpus. For example, what is the relationship between apoptosis and cancer? And the result is surprisingly relevant. Cancer cells are known to be protected from apoptosis, which is a major hurdle to successful anti-cancer therapy. So how difficult is this to do? It's actually pretty trivial. So I leveraged an open source API called Vault AI, which allows me to just upload documents, submit it to Ada for embeddings, and then I store it in Pinecone DB for later retrieval by the large language model. And in this case, I've uploaded 2,378 total documents, and I'm already able to get this kind of context. And by the way, I'm only using 3.5. If I was to be using GPT-4 or GPT-4 with 32K context, I would be getting phenomenally more complex answers than this. But it's a little more expensive, so trying to be a little more on the cheap side. But in totality, it took about 20 minutes to set this all up and $2 of expense for me to set this up. And adding more documents to it doesn't require any kind of retraining. It doesn't require me to create new taxonomic terms or ontologies or anything like that. All I have to do is upload documents. For example, if I wanted to upload another handful of documents, all I would have to do is drop it in. And if I pull up my command line and show it processing, it's just doing the embeddings for me and shooting them off for storage. And now I've added additional context to my corpus for search. And you can ask different questions than this as well. So for example, what would be some topics available to me? And apparently I can't spell today. And submit it off. And there we go. Risk estimation of developing breast cancer, computer-aided diagnosis for breast cancer detection, detection of control of cancer cells in the human body, and so forth. So incredibly relevant results with very minimal upfront effort. And to be honest, we could be doing things in a much more sophisticated way than we're doing here. For example, we could be leveraging the Llama Index or LangChain to further enhance our search experience. But this was meant to be an example of what could you do in 20 minutes if you wanted to enhance the search in your corpus. And I'm convinced that this is going to be transformative, especially in research areas where the science evolves quickly. Because in the past, when the science was evolving, we would have to update our control vocabularies, whether they were taxonomies or ontologies, to stay relevant in our research. But now we can allow our embeddings and our large language model to track the current state of our research and keep us current. And this is how humans want to search. We don't want to have to go through 20 or 30 research papers to stay relevant. We want to be able to jump to the most current research. And that is why companies like Google and these other search companies are so on fire to get caught up with OpenAI, because this is going to transform the landscape. If you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe, and please tune in next time when we're going to talk about how to fine-tune your large language model, including Vicuna, Llama, and OpenAI. Have a good one, everybody.